In this video, you will learn how to solve this nice exponential equation. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to my channel for more simplified mathematics solution. Now, to solve this video, I want you to note that the power of 4, that 4 can be equal to 2 times 2, right? 2 times 2 can give us 4. So that tells us that we can be able to simplify the power of 4 to smaller factor. And the next thing we need to do is to bring the 20 to the left-hand side. So let's get it started. We are going to have this to become x to the power of 2, right? All multiplied by 2 plus x to the power of 2 minus 20. We subtract 20 from both sides, the right hand side will be equal to 0. Great. So having gotten x to the power of 2, let's assume that let us let the value of x to the power of 2 to be equal to p. So for have x to the power of 2, let's make it to be equal to p. So since that is that, this equation will now give us p squared, right, plus p minus 20, and this will be equal to 0. Great. Now this forms a quadratic equation. Can this quadratic equation be simplifiable? Let's see. If we have a negative 20, we're going to look for two numbers we will multiply to give us a negative 20. And when we add such two numbers, we are going to have a positive 1, that is plus p. Now, what are those two numbers? Definitely, I know 5 multiplied by 4 is going to give us 20. Now, which of these two numbers will take the negative sign? Let's assign the negative sign to 4 and the positive sign to 5. Why? Because when we add these two numbers, the result it should give us should be a positive 1. So positive should be greater than what? Than the negative. So that gives us the result to become, this value will now be p squared, that is p squared minus 4p plus 5p minus 20, and this will be equal to 0. Great. So now we can simplify. If we simplify from these two parts, we'll see that p is common, right? We'll bring out 1p minus 4, right? And then we'll have a plus 5 is common. We'll have a p minus 4, and all these will be equal to 0. This is common simplification. So from here, we'll have p plus 5 to be equal to 0, or we'll have p minus 4 to be equal to 0. Great. Now, having done that, we're going to simplify those two separate equations. In the first case, we'll have p plus 5 to be equal to 0, right? And in the second case, we'll have p minus 4 to be equal to 0. So the value of p here, if we add p to both sides, if we add 4 to both sides, we'll have this to become 0 plus 4. And if this clears this, and then p will be equal to 0 plus 4 is equal to 4. So the value of our p is equal to 4, while on this side, if we subtract 5 from both sides, we'll have p plus 5 minus 5, and this will be equal to 0 minus 5. So this will clear this, and then our p will be equal to negative 5. Great. So we have two values, our p equal to negative 5 and our p equal to 4. Now recall that we said our x squared is equal to p, so we are going to simplify that. So remember that we have the expression x squared is equal to p, and we are asked to find the value of x. So from the first expression, we can now say that our x squared will be equal to negative 5. And on the other expression, we can say our x squared is equal to 4. So let's simplify these two expressions. To simplify that expression, this side is going to give us x squared equal to 5 multiplied by negative 1. So if we take the square root of both sides, we'll have the square root of x squared to be equal to the square root of what? 5 multiplied by the square root of negative 1. And recall that the square root of negative 1 is equal to imaginary. So we are going to have, if square clear square root, x will be equal to the square root of 5 imaginary, right? Great, that's the value of x. Now on this other side, we're going to take the square root of both sides. So we'll have x squared equal to the square root of 4. And the square root of 4 is what? Is 2. So our x will be equal to 2. So the values of our x are, x is equal to, the value of our x is x equal to the square root of 5 imaginary, which is an imaginary result, and then the value of what? Of our x equal to 2. So from the equation, from the question, we are asked to find the real values of x. So the solution to that question is x equal to 2, because that's the only real solution to this expression. Now let's check it out to see if the solution is right. X to the power of 4 plus x to the power of 2 equal to 20. If we insert the value of x equal to 2, will it give us a solution? X to the power of 4 plus x to the power of 2, is it going to give us 20? Now let's check that out. So we'll have 2 to the power of 4 plus 2 to the power of 2. Will it give us 20? Let's check that result out. 2 to the power of 4 is going to give us 16, right? Plus 2 to the power of 2 is 4. So this will be equal to 20. So what does that tell us? X equal to 2 is the right solution, the only real solution that satisfies the exponential equation given to us. The other solution, negative 5 imaginary, is an imaginary solution that also satisfies that exponential equation that is given to us up there. I know you did enjoy watching this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with friends and colleagues, and remember to subscribe to my channel for more simplified mathematics solutions. Thanks so much for watching, and bye-bye for now.